Hello, my name is Lauren Seltzer, and I will be your host for this edition of WTVE. If you were to think of fine cuisine, the average college student wouldn't be your first thought. Is it true that they only know how to prepare canned spaghetti and microwavable meals? During the next half hour, we are going to visit with various students and see if Temple students really are smarter in the kitchen. Our first stop is Stephanie's house, where her friends are attempting to prepare a tuna casserole.
I'm Sarah.
And I'm Hillary.
And we're at Steph's place today, and we're gonna cook our meal. And we're gonna see what she's got in here. We're not very good at cooking, but we'll see what we can scrape up from inside these cabinets here.
Milk?
Yeah, get the cheese out. First thing we should do is put the water in the pot.
Here.
While the water is boiling, we need to add cheese. What can we do next? Okay, we'll check the water, and it's not quite boiling yet, almost. Okay, then we'll add the soup and the cheese together to make a sauce. Boilage. This looks a little lumpy still. Oh, you know why that looks lumpy? It needs milk.
I forgot.
Milk. Okay, you keep stirring
in the fridge.
Okay.
Why is it like that?
Ew.
Fall or something?
If it sticks, it's ready.
Come on. Do what you were made to do. They're done. Really lumpy. Stop. Hold on, because you're going to have to use some of this. I don't know. Oh, really? I swear I do not trust this tuna. Something is not right. I'm not doing it alone.
And we don't?
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Cheers.
Yeah. Oh. Cheers.
Did you see any takeout menus while you were rummaging?
I think I did.
Steph's gonna be home soon, and we cannot use that for dinner. We're supposed to make dinner for her, and that is horrible.
Salad?
Chinese salad?
Yeah, do Chinese.
All right.
Hi, how you doing? Can I place an order for delivery, please? How long do you think that'll take? Okay, great. Thanks. Bye.
What is that smell? We tried to cook your food and it didn't work out.
You guys, it smells like bad fish and Chinese. What did you guys do to my apartment?
What is going on, you guys? Seriously.
Well, just sit down and eat. We got your favorite. You'll like it, I promise.
All right.
Well, the horrible fish smell is really horrible fish. It was bad tuna.
We Ew.
No, it was, yeah, it was bad.
What you got in my cabinet?
Yeah.
I'm sorry! All right, well, I'm just gonna indulge because I haven't eaten all day, and thank you so much for being such a good friend.
Well, as you can see, we tried to cook Steph's meal, but it didn't work, so takeout is always a plus.
Not everyone has kitchen savvy, but as we saw, when in doubt, order out. That's my motto. Now we move on to one of America's favorite pastimes, grilling out. Kick it!
Oh, good. You guys are here. Made it right on time. Hey, thanks for joining us, guys. My name's Brian. I'm going to give you a quick couple college tips on some college grilling and how we do things. First things we're doing, we got some regular chicken wings that we're going to be grilling up. We're going to season them, put them on the grill. Got some ribeye steaks here. Put some nice pepper on them. Not too much seasoning on them because they're some good steaks. Got some ground beef we're going to use for our hamburgers that we're going to be grilling. And we got some boneless strip steaks here. They're some tasty pieces of meat. When you're barbecuing, there's certain things that you need to know, like charcoal. Always got to use charcoal when you're barbecuing. Propane just doesn't cut it. All right, we just lit up the charcoal. That's going to take about 10, 15 minutes to heat up and get to where the temperature that it should be at. So what we're going to do right now is I'm going to season some of the meats real quick. And the steaks, you know, just add a little bit of pepper to them. You know, you don't need too much. Add a little bit of extra flavor to them. For the ground beef, we're just using some meat tenderizer. Adds a little bit of extra flavor into there for the burgers. Give them a little good flavor on that. And then for the ribeyes, what we're going to have to do is add a little bit of both. So we're going to start the cooking. We're going to start off with the chicken. Chicken's going to cook the slowest, take the longest to cook. So we're going to put this on the top rack, let it get some heat, and slowly cook while we put the meats on. While we're not going to bother putting any of the other meats on just yet, chicken's going to take a long while to cook, especially in the open top grill. So let that sit there for a while, and now we can have some fun while it's cooking.
Oh, perfect.
All right, now the chicken's just about all cooked on the inside, so we're going to put it down on the bottom level, get these skins fried a little bit up, and then we can throw on the steaks and get them ready for some cooking. So let's start out and put on the strip steaks. These are a little thicker. These are not for you too. You already got the burgers. Got these ribeyes, throw some of these on. All right, these steaks are ready to be flipped. Got about five minutes. Shouldn't be much longer than that. These things should be ready to go. And as you see, us being college students, we kind of do got to go with the utensils and cooking equipment that we have, which is why I'm using a fork rather than actual barbecue equipment. All right, these steaks are just about done now. The chicken, I underestimated the cooking time a little bit, so we're going to have to leave that on a little longer. But these steaks are looking pretty good, so we'll pull these out, see how these things are tasting.
Feel like that.
Not bad. All right, well, it looks like the chicken finally finished, so we're going to pull this off and see how we did with the chicken here. See how this stuff turned out? No, it's not too bad. May need a little hot sauce with it.
Empty plate? How'd you like that?
Excellent. It's the only way to do it. College.
I hope you enjoyed your college barbecue here. I know I certainly did. Liked the cooking. Food turned out pretty well. Steaks got eaten. Dog liked the burgers. Hope you guys enjoyed yourself.
That should satisfy any carnivore's tooth. But for all you health-conscious people or those looking to impress your date, here is something that you should enjoy.
Good afternoon. I'm Colin Moran. Tonight, I'm going to be cooking a fresh gnocchi, handmade, with a basil emulsion, Kalamata olives, and tomatoes. Completely vegetarian. It's how I like to eat sometimes. So I hope you enjoy it. As you may or may not know, potato gnocchi, or gnocchi, is pasta that we use potatoes with. The first thing to do is you cook your potatoes fully, and you have to peel them while they're hot. I never actually asked why, but it's just the way I've always done it, so. This is a ricer. There are many different types. This is just the one that I found probably was the cheapest or something. and this allows for more surface area so that the steam can escape from the potatoes. So these are rice potatoes. I allow for the potatoes to fully cook, which takes about, this is 6 pounds of potatoes. It took about 25 minutes. Then I peeled them while they were hot, allowed the steam to come out, and I riced them, which also continues the process of making them dry. When making pasta, just always sift your flour first, just to get any impurities out or incorporate some air to make it lighter. Then we start by incorporating them very slowly together. Gnocchi is supposed to be light and fluffy, so you have to work with it very quickly. Alright, now what you have to do is cut them into little strips. After you have them in these little cigar-like things, you just cut them like so. We're going to squeeze out the juices I've already done and place it inside our blender. For a little garnish and added color, I'm adding tomatoes. These are Roma tomatoes. I'm not a big fan of the seeds, so I'm just going to cut those out. And after I'm done with that, I'm going to small dice them. And I'm just going to throw those in at the end. Sauce, which is the basil emulsion I just did. For joining me. I hope you enjoyed our program, and I know that they did.
Healthy and good looking. That was great. Now most people can boil water, but to make something truly great takes a delicate touch.
You guys are hungry. Come on in. All right, guys. Today we're gonna make chicken mushroom Alfredo with linguine. All right, let's get started.
Sauce, I want to make it proportional. So I'm going to put that once down the middle, and once more on the other side, and then flip around, and about a quarter inch per every cut thereafter. And there you go. Now I am going to cut the chicken into small pieces. First in half. And then now I'm going to cut the exact same size as I did the mushroom. About a quarter inch. The chicken into the pan. Some salt and pepper on this. And some black pepper. Okay, now I'm gonna take this off. I'm gonna use the same pan that I fried the chicken in to pan fry the mushroom. Add a little bit more olive oil. Coat the whole entire pan. And put in the mushrooms. Put the butter in since it is simmering, a little at a time, and I'm gonna stir. Okay. Now I am going to put in the chicken and the mushrooms. I'm eyeballing about a cup and a half of cheese so I can put it in the Alfredo sauce. To use a box and a half, basically.
Okay guys, I know you guys are hungry today. Here's lunch. It's chicken and mushroom Alfredo with linguine. So dig in.
That looked great, guys. Now let's watch while Erin and her group create something on the lighter side.
I'm going to be cooking for you a shrimp Caesar salad. The Caesar salad consists of shrimp, ones that are deveined and raw. The Dole Caesar salad, which contains romaine lettuce, Parmesan cheese, croutons, and the Caesar dressing. So it is an entire package of a Caesar salad all in one. Some olive oil, doesn't matter if it's virgin or regular, but make sure it's olive oil. Some minced garlic for the shrimp, pepper, and salt. Okay, so what we're gonna do first is we're gonna take olive oil, and what I would say to put in is probably maybe 3 or 4 tablespoons. I don't use tablespoons, I don't believe in them, unless I'm using a strict recipe, so I just kinda pour it in a little bit so it coats the bottom so the shrimp don't burn. Next, we're gonna take the minced garlic and we're gonna put that into the bottom of the oiled pan. I put just about 1 really large tablespoon. That should probably be enough, maybe a little bit more for all you garlic fans. Okay, the one thing that you don't wanna do is that you don't want to actually turn this up too high, or you don't wanna cook it too long because then it will burn the garlic and it'll start to turn brown and it won't taste very well. See the shrimp are starting to turn orange. You want them to turn completely orange and kind of start getting a curl to them, but you don't want to cook them too much because then they become tough. And what you want to do is continuously, what I like to do is flip the shrimp, which gets all the oil coated onto it and it keeps it evenly cooking. So I just keep flipping it and then put it back down. I'm pretty convinced that they are done. So what we're going to do now is we're just going to leave them here and we're going to make the Caesar salad. So really simple, you just pour it into a bowl. Like that. This is the pouch that you use for the Caesar dressing, as it is labeled Caesar dressing. It's just very simple. Open up the pouch and pour it on top. And since we're making this for four people, we have to double it. So we're just going to open the two pouches up and pour the second one on. So now, after you have put together your lovely Caesar salad, you have to mix it. I would use this as primarily a summer meal. It is very light. It doesn't consist of much stuff, and it's not very hearty, so I wouldn't use it in the wintertime. It's very good in summer if you don't want something too heavy and you just want a real quick meal, then this is really the best way to go. So here you go, two bags of Dole Caesar salad later and shrimp and some garlic, pepper, and salt. You have a great meal. It's very cheap, very good, and wonderful for a college student. So the best thing for this meal is to go in the fridge and get a big, huge soda. Soda! We love soda with our salad. And remember, everybody, don't eat the tail.
No tail, you said, right?
No tail.
Here's to a cheap college meal. Yeah.
Mmm. Thank you.
Thank you.
And thank you for joining me on my quest to make shrimp Caesar salad. Yum.
What more could one ask for? Good food and friends. It's no doubt that you guys had fun cooking. Now, for a truly difficult task, watch while Christy tries to teach Ronit the art of desserts.
I'm Christy, and welcome to my kitchen. Today, we have a cooking challenge. We're gonna teach Ronit how to make a few simple desserts. Ronit, the first thing we're gonna make, which is very simple, is Jell-O. It's no carb, it's sugar-free, very popular, good for all those fad diets, and it takes just a few minutes. You ready?
Ready.
Put the Jell-O in, and right in there. Okay. And start stirring. We'll leave the oven mid aside. That's it. That's it. Now we're gonna put it in the fridge. And now it will chill. It says about maybe 2 hours. So now our next challenge for Ronnie is going to be the Jell-O no bake cheesecake.
So okay. How much butter do you need?
It says 6 tablespoons. So. See here? Each one says 1 tablespoon, 3, 4, 5. So you need 6. So we're going to cut it right there.
Cool.
So we're going to put the crust in the bowl.
That's fine.
And you want to scoop out 2 tablespoons of sugar into it.
This is 1. And 2.
What we're going to do, though, is we're going to wash our hands. And we're going to smush it up so it gets the whole side.
Oh, that sounds fun, dirty.
All evenly distributed throughout the pie crust. And we're gonna add in the milk and we're gonna beat that with the electric mixer for about 3 minutes.
So now you take these off somehow?
There is a release.
Very good.
That's okay.
It's in here. Okay.
That's all right. Add the filling into there.
So is there a special way to do it, or you just...
Just start pouring it in, and then we'll pat it all out evenly when you're done. So we're gonna put that in the fridge to chill. Well, Ronit, next is your big challenge.
Okay.
You're gonna bake cupcakes. Actually requires putting the oven on, several ingredients. Think you can do it?
Let's do it.
Think you can. Okay, first things first, you're gonna preheat the oven. This goes on to 350. You want to get all your ingredients out. Okay, so we need water, which is here, oil, and eggs.
This is lovely, like Sesame Street.
We're going to beat on low speed for about a minute.
This is really scary.
Okay, I'm going to put it in the oven. Now, cake is usually 40, 45 minutes. Now, these are individual, so they're gonna take a shorter amount of time to cook. So now our cupcakes are done.
This is ready, okay.
We want a good amount on there. You don't wanna be chintzy with your icing. So, get one on. Just get it all over. I have a whole bunch of different colored sprinkles that we can add to make it more festive.
Okay.
So why don't you sprinkle away?
I like the green ones.
Okay.
All inspired by Shrek.
Shrek? New Shrek? Okay. Mm-hmm. Now we have all three of our desserts that Roni made, each in just a few minutes. We're gonna try these together.
Go.
Bye.
It's like heaven.
Thank you.
We're gonna finish eating now, so see you later.
See you.
Ooh. I love that. I love that. Cool.
Uh-oh.
Decided that.
Well, they were really hot, and now they're bad.
Now we have. I like that. This is cool.
Oh.
Splat!
This is a new design of cupcake. It's a pita cupcake.
It's a pita. Stuff it with whatever you like.
Don't be so cake. Don't cry.
From start to finish, I think we've seen some really good dishes. Now we know that there can be more than pizza on the college student's menu. Thank you for your time. For ALTV, I'm Lauren Seltzer.
A bottle of red, perhaps a bottle of rosé instead. Get a table near the street in our old familiar place. You and I, face to face. A bottle of red. It all depends upon your appetite. I'll meet you anytime you want in our Italian restaurant. Long ago, you lost weight, I did not know. You ever looked so nice after so much time.